Let's start the installation. The box is outside the clinic, or if you had the double wooden case, it's probably already inside. Start unpacking the unit and bring all the small cartons in the room where you would like to install the dental unit. Keep all packs next to the wall so you have all the space to place the chair and its big components. To simplify the handling through the doors and different floors, it is important to disconnect the whole instrument tray, starting from its connections inside the water unit. Remove the water unit covers and bring them inside. All tubes and wires coming from the instrument tray must be disconnected. Start from the small tubes where they have junction. Disconnect the small green one, the red one, the blue one, the big black one, the yellow one on the metal separator. On the opposite side of the water unit, open the cable holders and follow those from the instrument tray to the board. Remove them and remove the ground wire. Slip off the wires and tubes just disconnected. Join the instrument tray arms with some tape to keep those in a better position and prepare something on the floor inside the room to lay the instrument tray once removed. Take out the connector holder at the base of the chair and disconnect the white cables of the monitors. Unscrew the two black box screws and the two of the white metal structure to remove it from its place. Remove the four biggest screws that keep the water unit on its stand. Before removing the last one, please ensure that someone is keeping the water unit balanced. Lay down the entire water unit near you or inside the clinic on a soft surface. Take out the two screws that keep the back plastic cover of the chair. Remove the cover and place the back of the screws on a metal surface. Bring the cover inside the clinic. Remove the screws that keep the dental chair on the wooden pallet. Take the chair inside the clinic. You can use a cart if you have it. It will simplify handling the heavy chair. Call an extra person to help you for a couple minutes. It's time to place the water unit in position. The water unit can be outside the clinic or inside the clinic. It depends where you have more space to do this operation. Place it on its metal stand and fix it with the four big screws while someone is keeping it balanced. Place it back to its position on the metal white stand and the black box. Fix it with the screws previously loose. Connect the two white wires of the monitor and lock with the holder. pack the tubes and the wire of the instrument tray with some tape. Place the back of the instrument tray in its original position. Pay attention to connect the locking screw inside the water unit. Now it's time to reconnect the tubes and wires of the instrument tray inside the water unit. Bring the wires on their side, reconnect the fast connectors, place the ground wire in its position, and close the wire holders to keep them in the correct position. Red, green, blue, black, and yellow tubes must be reconnected. And the installation of the instrument tray is finished. Unpack the lamp arms box. Remove the lamp pole and place its holder up on the water unit. Open the box of the smaller parts and remove the silicone gray ring. Place it on the lamp vertical pole to cover the joints at the base. Use the white plastic ring to join the lamp's arm to the lamp's pole. Insert the wire into the right side of the water unit and join the arms to the pole. Connect the lamp's wires that you have just inserted into the water unit board following the color indicators. If you have an LED lamp, just connect the two wires you find on the blue connector of the board or to the connectors previously installed by our technician. Close the right side of the water unit. Open the lamp box. Connect the wire connectors. Take out the screw. Insert the lamp on the lamp pole and lock it. Take the spittoon in your hand and insert the tubes into the water unit. If you are installing a glass spittoon, pay attention to insert the silicone ring before the tubes. Do not have the same ring if you are installing a ceramic spittoon. If you remove the solenoid valve's holder, you can easily place the red and blue tubes of the spittoon in its place. Just note that blue goes with blue and red with red. Close the tube rings and place back the solenoid valve in its position. Connect the drain corrugate pipe on the Y connector. The free tube you find on the other Y branch is just for air. It must not be connected anywhere. Look for basin taps, filter, and filter ceramic top on the plastic bag. Insert the glass spittoon and the parts just removed from the bag. Small tap is for the basin, big tap is for the glass. Get back to the plastic bag and bring the three biggest screws in your hand. Insert the backrest in position and lock with the screws. Push the headrest in the hole you find on the backrest. A mechanical friction will keep it in place. Place the seat of the chair and push it back a little to fix it correctly. Then lock with two small screws in the front. You can now adjust the chair base just working on the regulator screws on the base. This operation must be done if the floor surface is not regular. This operation will permit to stabilize the chair and avoid shaking or incorrect balance of the instrument arm. Place back the plastic cover and lock it with its screws. Follow the instructions in our videos to make a correct connection with wires and pipes coming from the floor. Connect the suction motor, if you have any, on the pink connector. Note, this operation depends on the valve you have installed on the unit. It's not always the same. Regulate the air valve on 6 bar and the water valve on 4 bar. Put the main on-off button in position 2. It will permit you to control the electricity of the chair just by opening and closing the side lever. Place the chair base front cover. Remove all chair packaging and protections safely and accurately. Please do not scratch the chair surface with scissors or cutters. Put the cartons on the pallet. Place the feet cover. Insert adapters for suction and the metal tips of the syringes. All the silicones in their position and the game is done. Please check that everything is working correctly and ensure to clean the clinic before leaving it. Please be sure to explain the chair functionality to doctors. A good explanation is important for your and our image. If you do a correct job, you will stay out of the clinic for a while. Doctors will be happy to work with Simple&smart chair and happy to avoid frequent assistance needs. Thank you for choosing Simple and Smart.